What's up everybody, it's your boy Izzy from Powerlifting to Win, and in today's video we're going to be talking about these bad boys right here. These are the SABO PowerLift, weightlifting shoes. I don't know what to call them. The name is kind of confusing. The name of the shoe is the PowerLift, and these are in fact weightlifting shoes made specifically for powerlifters. Now, most of us out here already know that if you're a raw powerlifter, you will likely benefit from a heel, especially if you have ankle mobility problems. But really, a lot of people just lift more in a heel because it shifts some of the leverage towards the quads, and the quads are important in a raw squat. So that's all fine and dandy. Weightlifting shoes help powerlifters, we know this, but the problem comes into the picture because we also know that most high-end weightlifting shoes cost anywhere from like $150 to sometimes $200. And here's the thing, as powerlifters, the demands that we have on a weightlifting shoe are going to be less than that of an actual Olympic weightlifter. We don't need a light shoe because we're not trying to get under a snatch or get under a clean and jerk real fast. In fact, we don't need to move fast at all, like ever. We're powerlifters, right? So we don't have the same demands. You don't need a flexible forefoot. You don't need some of the things that jack up the cost of a regular Olympic weightlifting shoe. Now, here, in my opinion, are the five things that you do want in a weightlifting shoe as a powerlifter. One is durability. You don't want to pay $100, $150, $200 for a shoe that's going to fall apart on you in 6 months. That's ridiculous. Nobody should be doing that. It's just, even if you could afford it, it's just dumb. Second thing is comfort. The last thing that I personally want is painful feet, as you know, my entire body is aching and struggling to finish a heavy squat set. The third thing, and perhaps in terms of effectiveness, the most important thing that you want to consider here is, does the shoe have a metatarsal strap? And as you can see, the PowerLift here actually has two straps, one on the metatarsal and one that's a bit lower down there. And really, your foot is not going anywhere in this shoe. These straps suck your foot into the shoe. They prevent any pronation or supination of the foot during the movement, and that's going to increase your lifting efficiency. The fourth thing that I want you guys to consider is whether or not the heel material is compressible. So if you guys have seen my other video on powerlifting shoes, you actually saw me take a pair of Chucks, and just using my fingers, I was able to squish the sole of a pair of Chucks. Now, if you're under 500 pounds, 400 pounds, 600 pounds, 700 pounds, and the sole of your shoe is squishing, you're losing force transfer efficiency there, and you're going to actually just waste pounds on your squat. Now, you might have to train for months to add 10 pounds to your squat, to even add 5 pounds to your squat. Do you really want to just throw that away by using a crappy pair of shoes? Well, I don't, and that's why I look for a shoe with a non-compressible sole. These fit that bill. And the last thing that you're looking for is the heel height, right? The effective heel height, which is the difference between the front of the shoe over here and the back of the shoe. Now, the SABO PowerLifts have an effective heel height of about 3/4 of an inch, which is really the standard nowadays, and it's what works best for most people. If you're really tall, you might want something taller. And if you tend to get forward on your squat, or if you're real short, you might want something shorter. Wide stance squatters, not universally, but lots of real wide stance squatters also prefer a flat shoe. But for the rest of us, 3/4 of an inch is generally just what the doctor ordered. So, with those five things in mind, I want to go ahead and give you guys a little tour of the shoe, so to speak. All right, guys, we're going to put the shoes center stage now instead of just me. I have had these things for basically months now, so you can tell that they are worn, but what you can't tell really is that they're falling apart at all, which is exactly what you want in a shoe that you're going to pay hundreds of dollars for. I mean, to me, and I'm not by any means like a shoe aficionado or some crazy stuff like that, but they really don't look that worn at all, and I have been using these things almost every single day for 3 or 4 months now. Here's the bottom of them. You can see the traction, some chalk, I guess, that got stuck in there. Back of the shoe, it does have this little logo right here. Yeah, it's a good pair of shoes. I use them. I have no complaints. I think they meet the bill. They're obviously not going to like blow your mind and add 40 pounds to your squat overnight or some ridiculous claim like that. But if you're looking for a pair of shoes that is, you know, cheaper than $200, go to Max Barbell. Max Barbell has always treated me right. Anything I've ever ordered for them, I've gotten within really 2 days. I can't remember anything taking longer than that. If you're in the States, guys, Max Barbell is the way to go. And these things are $120 right now, and they're on sale. So if you want to get them before the price goes up, I would do that. But if that's too expensive for you, Max Barbell also has some shoes on sale right now for like $45, the Wayrees. So really, if you're looking for an alternative to like the $200 pair of like Adidas or Nikes, Max Barbell is the way to go. I can't recommend them enough. And yeah, guys, that's really all I got for you. I hope that helped, and I hope that answered the questions you guys had about the SABO Powerlifts. And as always, my friends, check out PowerliftingToWin for more great powerlifting information, and have a nice day.